Hello there, welcome, yes, to D-Light Channel, Development, Empowerment and Leadership Initiative. This is an NGO where we have a vision of world transformation, one man at a time, one community at a time. And I've lost count now. Over the last couple of weeks, we have been focusing on retirement. And today we're about 3,000 feet above sea level, going towards landing. And we will be continuing the conversation on how do you prepare for retirement. We focus broadly on three areas. One has to do with the cognitive, the second had to do with the behavioral, and the recent episodes has been about financial preparation. And in talking about financial preparation, I've spoken about entrepreneurship, direct and indirect, as one of the means of retirement preparation. I've also spoken about real estate as one of your means to financial preparation. If you've missed any of these episodes, please go back and watch. But there's something common to what we've been talking about in terms of financial preparation, and that is creating assets. We have also said, as far as we are concerned, that asset is not just something that you own. Asset is something that pays you. Therefore, this week, we are moving a bit further to say that if you are listening and you are at a point where you can start early to prepare for retirement, one other element of financial preparation you may want to consider is the financial instruments. And I use that umbrella broadly. So I'm talking about the money market instruments, I'm talking about the treasury bills, I'm talking about even equity or stock acquisition on the stock exchange. So what I'm saying in essence is that if you have succeeded in living under a budget, meaning that you have been able to create some savings, you can actually apply those savings into financial instruments that will yield you returns. The best time really to invest in financial instruments is when you don't necessarily need those returns. Because like everything in life, most of those instruments go through cycles. And no matter what you do, there will be a period of bust, there will be a period of boom. But if you have done the required thing, which is what I'm really trying to focus on right now, to be sure of exactly what you are investing in the long run, you would have a healthy position that would not just generate cash by way of dividends and interest, but also that will keep your principal valuable and improving. And let me try and break that down in a bit. What I'm saying in essence is this. If you have been able to generate some savings, you can put them into financial instruments. How? One, you must understand the fundamentals of the instruments you are trying to invest in. If you do treasury bills, you know that it's issued by government, and the rate and the tenor and the terms are known, and unless the country goes kaput and everything goes down, you are almost certain that once it is up for redemption, it will either be redeemed or it will be rolled over. So depending on whether you are now under pressure to cash out, or you still have the window to recycle it, you are in safe hands. You don't necessarily have any fear that your investment in treasury bills can disappear. However, we have also seen government go bankrupt. So it's something you want to keep your eye on. But in terms of the risk, it's one of the instruments with the lowest risk. And of course, the returns are not necessarily very outrageous. But it is predictable and you can plan with it. If you want to do the money market instruments as well, they vary from institution to institution depending on the rules of the government as to who can play in that space. But what you typically will find is that when you put your money, your savings into money market instrument, immediately generates interest for you, which sometimes or most of the time is paid upfront, which you can then utilize for other things. And at the end of the term, your principal comes back and you can embark on that journey several times. Again, this is tied to the survival and the health of the central bank of the country and the financial climate of the country at any point in time. Relatively, it is safe. Unless something drastic happens, you don't have any concern that your interest plus principal will come out. The third option, which I would like to speak about, is the stock ownership, or what we call shareholding. That will require some elaboration, and therefore, I will plead that you allow me push that onto the next video. And then I will have all the space I require to go through it and hopefully lead us to the last video, I hope, on this matter of retirement. So, if this has made sense to you, then you sure want to keep it a date with me next week as we continue the conversation. Until then, don't ever forget, the channel is Delai, the name is T-Mac, and all we are trying to do here is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next week. Bye.